you want. Leave us alone.
How's it going, yes. Dude?
All right. It's the Arcast with Jeff Lafferty and Gibbon Redinger. And, yeah, man, here to draw another 2 hours tonight. How you feeling, Jib? You there?
Yeah, I'm here. Can you not hear me?
Yeah, I hear you.
Hello? Okay.
I do hear you.
I'm running about that slow.
Yeah, I know. Man,
that panel is looking nice, Jeff.
Oh, thanks. I got that finished up. Finished up today. I've been trying to get a panel done every day, identical last 3 days. So I feel like I'm pushing through a little better. Yep.
Nice.
Getting some momentum going here. But yeah, I don't know, man. I noticed like today is the last day of Comic-Con. Did you know that?
Mm-hmm. Oh, online.
Yeah.
San Diego Comic-Con online.
Yeah.
Stupid.
Super lame. Even lamer than the usual San Diego Comic-Con, which I personally think the San Diego Comic-Con is the worst con there is now. What do you think about that?
Yeah. There you go.
Yeah, I mean, they fell the furthest, I think, of all the cons, of all the shitty fucking, Super 8 cons that I've ever been to. I think that San Diego is like, you know, it's went down further than any of them. Because it was actually a cool con at one time, but, you know, nowadays, it's just a media circus, man.
Just a hashtag this year. You put that hashtag up, you can say you were part of it. That part of San Diego Comic Con.
We are. We're the official critics of the San Diego Comic Con.
All right.
And it's because I say so.
There it is. Isn't that all you have to do this year?
Yeah, and it's the internet, and they can't keep me the fuck out like they've done for years and years.
Maybe you haven't heard of this dude named Alex Jones.
Yeah.
All right, they tried.
They tried to keep you, Alex Jones, out of the Comic Con, or then,
no, not out of the Comic Con, off the internet.
Off the internet, yeah.
Yeah, it's all right.
Well, Alex Jones. Yeah. I mean, he's still got his website, so they still couldn't get him completely off the internet.
No, they can't get him off as long as he's willing to pay to have a site.
Yeah, which sucks. I mean, it's just a typical fucking. Mm-hmm. Whatever. I hate to like say all the stupid buzzwords, but the cancel culture. culture. I got to use that stupid new word.
So how are we getting canceled, Jeff?
That's what it all is now, right? No, I don't know. I was like noticing all these videos, like these 2020 Comic-Con videos, all these smiling, happy people acting like Comic-Con was like, you know, happening.
Yeah.
I think it's great it didn't happen, man. Comic-Con is terrible. I mean, it's basically what's wrong with comics, right? Because, like, you go to Comic-Con and it's not even about comics. And, you used to be able to go there and get... What's up? You're stopping my rant, but what's going on?
I'm sorry. I was saying, you can still get your Funko Pop, so everything's good.
Yeah, I hate Funko Pops too. I don't know why those things are popular.
Sorry, I didn't mean to derail you there this time. Just this once.
It's all right.
But I just thought it was weird that you could still get the exclusive Comic-Con toys on the. I guess it's just on the internet. Where do you go to get these things? Target? What's the deal? You know, you're not going to Comic-Con to get them. How are they exclusive?
Yeah, but these Funko, you can just, I could just buy one of these Funko Pops and just fucking paint a Berserker model on them. You can just make your own fucking exclusive anything. They're all the same shape. They're exact same toy. Mm-hmm. When's people going to figure that out?
Oh, it's true. Never.
Yeah.
Pure gold, dude. But so yeah, you're not digging on the Comic-Con.
No,
you weren't anyway, but this year more than ever.
Yeah, I don't really care one or the other. But yeah, it's just, I don't know. Just noticed it going around and decided, God, how stupid is this? Anyway, I'm off my rant already. Now I lost my
voice. Uh-oh. Sorry. I got you. I kicked you off, dude. Sorry.
Rant is over. No. No. Let's see. The old blue pencil. I was thinking about what's up.
I was gonna say, this is how I throw you under the bus at the beginning of this thing, you know. We don't want mad at Comic-Con a day before your birthday, Jeff.
Oh God, don't even remind me. If you want to fully stress me out, then remind me about my birthday.
There it is.
And I'm already at 98%, Jeff. Don't antagonize me today.
Today's not the day.
Salazar's in the chat. I was thinking about either throwing the link into the chat, letting some people come on, or maybe just inviting Frank. If Frank feels like drawing. What do you think, Jim?
Go for it, dude. It's good. Jeff's already mad at me. See that, guys? He's like, damn it, you knocked me off my rant. You mentioned my birthday. Get somebody else in here. Already.
Abe's here. Anyway. Hey, let's get all the entire chat onto the show today.
Yeah, let's see what we can do. Randy, get in here. Come on, Frank. Abe, you went in?
Randy's coming. In, guys.
Oh, are you? Nope, Randy.
He can come on too, though. I don't know how many people. Who wants to come on? You guys want to come on?
Get, what, 9, 10 people on? Let's make this a party. Geez.
Those shows are so bad, though. But, I mean, you know, at least I won't have to talk. Okay, I'll tell you what. You guys can come on, but you got to, like, tell me why Comic-Con sucks this year. Or, no, Comic-Con sucks in general. Not just this year. It sucks in general. It's like, you know, the death knells of the industry. Abe says, I'm game. Just need to kick some people out of my living room. Should I throw it in the chat or should I just
you're a wild man, Jeff.
Just a wild man it into you're the chat.
Yeah. Oh my goodness, dude. I spray painted this thing right before we started and I may have to go throw this thing back outside. It is giving me a fucking headache.
Stinking you out. Yeah.
Yeah, dude. Ooh, rough. Hit me hard here.
All right, there's the link in.
There it is. Jump in.
How come you never capitalize the G on your
name? I just ignore the background.
That's what I want to know. Why is this G not capitalized? I think he's frozen. I'm a heathen. Is that why?
Heathens don't capitalize yet. Letters or use punctuation. I don't know, dude. I'm just lazy. That's just one extra button to push when I'm putting the fucking name in. Didn't hit it.
I see. All right. Looks like Creed came out.
I'm sorry. What's hey, up, Creed?
Hello, fellas.
How you guys? How you doing?
Oh, not too bad. Just working on some art.
Oh, good deal.
I love that this show schedules. If I'm up at night, it schedules 2 hours of art for me. It's awesome.
Perfect. Yeah, it forces me to do 2 hours of art. Well, maybe
I think just as you change this show.
Yeah.
Yeah. The button to start it is like, you know, it's like it goes straight to Jim. It's like electro wired into his brain. It's like time to work.
I'm sitting here 15 minutes before the show starts, just waiting for the message.
Really?
Not no. Hell no. I'm trying to get kids to sleep and in any other room, and the house shut down, and like, oh my God, show's gonna, yeah, you know, waking my wife up right now, yelling. It's all good.
Yeah.
But yeah.
She's glaring at you.
No, I just heard her move.
Sunday night, she needs sleep.
Hell yeah. And I'm here and here hyped up on energy drinks and alcohol, having a blast. You know. God, yeah, this painting's got to go out, dude. I'm sorry, guys. I'll be right back. This painting's going to kill me.
2 seconds. This is the show where Gibran goes out the window and he's not on the show anymore. He escaped. You weren't watching close enough, Jeff. You can't let him have bathroom breaks. That's against the rules, you know.
I know. We need someone to go with him.
There better not be a window in there. I'm telling you, he's gone. I've seen too many 70s detective shows to know this.
Yeah, absolutely. All right. You know, I actually got struck for, I don't know if you saw those cartoons I was putting up yesterday, but I got struck for the one that where the kid falls in the lava or whatever.
Oh, yeah.
Alakazam. So yesterday's video is like, is blocked in Japan for some reason.
Oh, no. That's. So. And your empire begins to crumble.
I know. I don't know if I have people from Japan watching my show.
You were just going to take over all of, like, from the north down to Mount Fuji. No, I don't know the geography. I don't know.
Yeah, I don't know, man.
YouTube is picky. Like, it seems like they strike everything, but they strike random. You never know what they're going to strike. That's worse.
Yeah, I know. And I figured old cartoons I'd probably be safe.
Yeah.
Because I got nailed for when I was showing that Primal cartoon. I don't know if you're watching.
Oh, yeah. I saw that too.
Yeah. They got me that, like, right off the bat. But I thought, well, it's new, you know. So.
But, I always wanted to add little clips in the corner of my videos, but I stayed away from it. I think I'm going to at least try that. Just if I can just make little, like, I don't know, tiny clips. I don't know.
Well, that could be. I think so, yeah. I think that might be part of, like, my deal. Like, when I full screen it or something, you know, it's all right there.
Yeah.
But.
YouTube's temperamental, but they let us host video for free, so can't complain.
That's true.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I just can't get
bathroom,
over there.
Bathroom window was jammed. Gibran's still here. Awesome.
Yeah, here I am. Boom. I just threw that painting outside, dude, ran back in. You know, but yeah, I can't believe I couldn't put that little birthday mic video up at all. That was crazy.
Oh yeah,
that for me. And, I mean, there's far worse stuff all over YouTube, dude.
Yeah, definitely. I'm pretty amazed that they weren't even naked. They were just the pasties.
They were just jiggling.
So let's see. Looks like people are having trouble getting in. Every time I try to click the link, it won't let me go in. Let me send it through Facebook to you. Randy, you can come in too if you want, or you can just wait till tomorrow. Let's see. I guess there's got to be somebody in the chat, right, Creed? Oops, I sent it to Jim.
It's like that John Denver. There we go. I'm coming. Everybody pile in.
Yeah, let's just see. Right. Party, dude. It's a party. It's a party going on. Wake my wife up, I'll fucking start hooking up music instruments. I'll start playing the drums. Boom, 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 boom. Hey, babe, they asked me to play some drums. Hope you're cool with that. Blast me.
If you have a request, just scream.
Just let me know. Apparently, I'm doing Freebird about 20 times. Hold on. Yeah. Let's make that happen.
Yeah. Let's see. So I threw that link in the chat. I threw it into your Facebook page. You can find it there.
So the last day of the weekend, or the first day of the week, Sunday. Oh man.
So here he comes, it's like, I don't know why it didn't work for him over there, but Hey, Frank. How's it going, man?
Hey. Let me just set this up.
Abe says,
you're not brandishing any weapons, are you?
Not today.
Okay.
Yeah. Abe says people won't go and now crickets are chirping. It don't matter, Abe. If you want to come in later, you know, if we're still going, just jump in whenever you want to.
Oh, yeah.
Got my Berserker Knot tattoo.
There it is. Check it out, man.
Oh, man.
You need to put that on something, man, so like bitches can see it.
I'll put
it
on Facebook.
They'll just be swooning all over you. And then walk around with your sketchbook like this, and I'm telling you, there's 4 dates in 1 week.
Ladies.
That sticker is like Stetson Cologne, bro. But I've heard it's like high karate.
I put it on my make your comic book.
It just pulls. It will pull the wool itself.
Yeah. Just be careful, man. You'll be tripping on panties wherever you go.
That sticker is called a panty dropper.
No, I'm actually impressed by how that sticker came out.
Yeah, and the printing's really good from the pictures anyway.
Yeah.
I was like, yeah, it's a good size. Surprise. Yeah.
It's good for
I thought it was.
Yeah.
Randy's fixing to get in here. Get in here, Randy.
Yeah.
It's there. A good size. It's always good when somebody says it's a good size, Frank.
Yeah.
No.
You never know how those third party places are going to do though.
Jesus. Yeah, you're right. So it's like the only one sold, huh, Jeff? You got limited, rare, limited sticker there apparently.
Well, you know, I did. Yeah, I know. Yeah, maybe I'll put it back up. I don't know. But you know,
I just every time I did it.
But now the Berserker Knot t-shirt is in, what's it? What is it? It says it's being reviewed or something. So like it won't show up on YouTube. And then I noticed the Bigfoot t-shirt, like both my t-shirts are like back in review. So the Bigfoot teacher wasn't in review, was it?
I don't think so. It's not there right now. I mean, I'm going off to look. It might be a 2-second echo. I can't stand this.
But yeah, no, I mean, it wasn't, but now they freaking put it back in review. I don't understand what this, what they're doing.
I find those t-shirt places to be the touchiest places for like uploading art. Anywhere else I upload, there might be one or two things they'll say no to. T-shirt place, they'll say, even if they say yes, they might say no later. And then, or you get lots of no's when you're trying. Like I uploaded like mashup stuff that's mine. Like I made it up from two things. And they're like, no, one of those things is copyright. I'm like, yeah, they're both copyright. But then number three is by me. You know, that's how mashups work. I don't know.
Yeah, you'd think that would be almost like parody if you're doing that.
Oh yeah,
but that it's not actually on Teespring. It's like the link between Teespring and my channel. So like the display on that little bar is where it goes into review. So it's actually on Teespring if you get over there, but it won't show up on the bar here.
Oh, it's YouTube being touchy this time.
Yeah, it's like YouTube.
Oh no.
But what's crazy is that wasn't the Bigfoot shirt. Yeah. In the bar at one point.
Yeah, the Bigfoot shirt was in there, and I haven't messed with it, so it's like I don't understand like why it's.
It's Frank's rogue algorithm. That's what's going on. Drilling holes.
Is it because they think it's anti-masks?
It could be. I don't know. Like you'd think they would just like, you know, just get take it down or something. It was something like that, you know, just tell me no instead of under review.
It's under review. You're in trouble, Jeff. You're going to the principal's office.
Yeah.
The Whisper Network complained.
Right.
Comic Loudly, which is ironic.
Yeah, really? They got some big mouths being Whisper Network.
Yeah.
We got the Grumble Network back at them, so tough.
There you go. Yeah, anyway, I guess it'll work itself out eventually, but how many people can join at a time? So I think I can get like 9 in or something, but
yeah, you know. It can get wild. I think 9 people.
It's a small car, so when you get in, tuck your knees.
Yeah. I don't know. Once we get like 3 or 4, I'm sure.
It's going to get crazy, Jeff. It's going to get crazy. And then Jeff's going to get knocked out of here. And then it's going to be wild. We're like, raise hell. It's like fucking Road Warrior. In this
Whoever's
bitch.
Talking the loudest gets heard the most.
Oh, yeah. That's when I start screaming.
Can you fucking hear me? I wonder. Yeah, like, you know how I get knocked out sometimes, like if my internet goes down and then like all leaves the stream, but then the stream continues. And I wondered, like, you know, if my internet didn't come back on or something, I mean, is this thing just going to run and run?
Ever.
Probably.
I mean, for Pete's sake, man, talk about lose control of your channel.
YouTube, don't worry, YouTube's at the wheel.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah. You come, yeah, dude. You wake up the next morning, you realize that you're still streaming, and you click on it, and it's a bunch of Russians on there. Duh. Like, what the hell's going on? Damn Russians have stolen my channel. No!
With Comrade Jeff.
Yeah, with Comrade Jeff. You can go hang out with Commie Mark. Commie Mark and Comrade Jeff. There it is.
No, it'll be Commie Mark and Russell being here.
Did Commie Mark ever get back to you?
Yeah, he just said he fell back asleep, and so he told me to try to come on next time. He's got a day off, so you know. He said, "Let me know whenever you want to."
He says he spits at America. That's what he said. Yeah, he said he spits at America.
Yeah.
And he'll only come on the show once Grandmaster Emperor stops the sun from moving. I don't know. I don't know.
Yeah, I don't know. I think we should, like, boycott China, though. And, like, all these guys who do Kickstarters and print over there in China, I think we should all just be like, oh, screw you guys. Not buying your Chinese shit.
There it is. Your
coronavirus crap coming over here.
Even just because the economy's tanking, you got to buy local whenever you can. That's the only way your local place is going to still be here.
Yeah. The comics especially. It's like, what are they saving by going over there? Anyway? Like $2 on their book, you know? Like no reason for it. So I'm against everything tonight. Against Comic-Con, against China.
There we go.
What else you got?
Cantankers in your old age.
Yeah, right. Jesus, Jeff.
Well, it's day 53. I'm like sick of this shit, you know?
There you go.
Let's see.
Day 54 is going to be like Murder Monday for Jeff. He's going to be like, oh, shit.
Elijah says, I support that, but I don't know how possible that is. You mean boycotting the Chinese books? A lot of local shops around here didn't make it. That sucks, Crystal.
Oh.
Randy's here. Well, this is cool. I've never seen like this many people in here. So we got 3 across the top and 2 side by side.
Yeah.
Welcome, Randy.
And Randy.
What's up, guys?
Yeah, you're next to Randy. I'm sitting next to Gib.
We're the 2 comic skate guys.
Yeah, I don't think y'all are 6 feet away from me, dude. I need a social distance y'all's asses away.
We have to stay 6 pixels apart.
Yeah. 6 pixels, okay. Hold on, let me go put my mask on.
That'd be an unsharp mask.
Yeah. Oh, nice. Are you going Comic State, Frank? You're not going Comic State, are you?
No. But what do you show? Do you show up there?
No, but Frank, yeah. Randy put out a tweet and he tagged me in it about Comic State, so now I've been out.
Oh,
what, are people attacking you? Or what? Are people attacking you or what?
Way to drag us all down.
No, one cares.
That's great.
No one cares about me.
That's awesome. Oh, they will soon enough. Now, let the seed grow, Frank. Let the seed grow.
Comic Skate Frank. That nickname will spread. Don't worry about it.
Oh, yeah. I already hear that. That's a good one. Comic Skate Frank. CG Frank. No, but what was it? It was because it's Randy Ravel Rouser Ziplon. That's a superhero name. It's a supervillain name.
Starting it up.
Yeah, that's it. Why are you dragging Captain Courage into the underbelly of comic books, Randy?
I'm sorry.
That's it.
He'll be okay. He's a big boy. He can handle it.
Yeah, that's great. Good times.
He'll probably like
in Twitter.
Oh, yeah, I tweeted something that the indie comics match thing, and I hashtag Comicsgate, and then I like tagged him and Jeff in it.
Awesome.
Oh, on Twitter?
You're like throwing mud at me.
It didn't say that you were part of Comicsgate. I mean, this is...
No.
And there you go. You're in, dude.
You're in.
You're fucking in. Show up and fucking kiss the ring and booyah! It's fucking on.
You don't want any of that.
Seems to be the new Kick Me sign.
It's kind of even talking about Comicsgate is kind of gets you in some trouble, you know.
Hell yeah, it does.
Yeah, I was just watching a video of a guy that he says he's SJW, but he's kind of talking about how he kind of agrees with some of the Comicsgate stuff. Because just the other side has been coming on so strong, and I'm not gonna say who because it's a comic creator, but he was tagging him in the comments and also on one of the other Facebook groups. And like, why? You're like, you don't need to.
The only thing that bugs me about Comicsgate is they seem to be everywhere. Did you hear Frank even joined? Jeez.
Yes.
It's spreading like wildfire. They got Frank.
Damn. So when's Captain Courage coming out to Indiegogo? So we can see them three numbers on Indiegogo there, man. Huh?
Well, that's probably when I will turn to Comicsgate.
There you go. I can't do that. I love you all of a sudden.
Six figures, young lady.
There you go, man. Get on it.
Even CB's out here. We have CB come on. Do you want to come on?
Oh, again, dude. Oh, yeah. No, now it's a show. Now it's a family reunion.
We're anti Comic Con, pro Comic State.
Comic Con sucks.
There it is.
I thought everybody would all into that Comic Con sucks, but everybody seems to be like, yeah.
I'm down.
They really pissed me off.
I've never been to an actual Comic Con.
Yeah.
So I've just been to like a local one. Those are right. But I've never been to the main one. So.
Yeah. Well, Comic Con has just gotten so big and.
It's unwieldy. Not about comics anymore either.
Yeah. It's definitely not about comics.
That's what Scott Circle was saying. And if he says it, it must be true.
Yeah. It's gospel.
Oh, yeah.
I really hate it this year. They were saying, oh, we're going to have it at your place. I don't have enough chairs for that.
Yeah, right.
You know, you can't just jump that on me.
Well, I've been selling tickets though. I've been selling tickets online. So I still need a ticket. Let me know. Hell yeah.
You want VIP? That comes with a chair.
Hell yeah. There you go. Yeah. Comes with a free Squirrel Girl comic book. Oh yeah.
Yep.
With that for $3 more, you don't get the Squirrel Girl comic book.
Exactly.
No, I'm just kidding.
Who wants that?
Get your picture taken with the stripper dressed up like Squirrel Girl.
Hell yeah. Dressed up. What kind of Comic-Con down. Jeff. She ain't wearing nothing. Stripper. Classy.
That's why I need. For only $20, Neil Adams will give you the finger.
Yeah. Yeah. He'll cleanse you of your whiteness.
Yeah. Oh, God.
Yeah, what it? I mean, that Neil Adams stuff was pretty damn funny.
I always hear stuff like he's a brilliant artist. There's no question about that.
Yeah.
But it's all the other stuff, and he does a reasonable job of keeping it quiet. But you hear stuff if you're like into even comics or whatever art or whatever, that he's like one of the biggest assholes in the whole industry. And you know, but you know what? That's fine. He does good art. That's what I like him for. I don't like him for art. Is he an asshole or not? You know, I don't care. I like him for his art. So whatever.
Yeah, I agree. I mean, I'm not like, you know, let's cancel Neil Adams or anything, but
they kind of go, oh, I want a clip of somebody like ranting and grumbling. Let's ask Neil Adams something. And he always like, oh, he rambles on about whatever they asked him. It's just, you know, they're just going for the easy one. You know, Neil Adams is going to say something cranky.
Yeah. Yeah.
The only one I really agreed with him on, they had a little clip, and they had him at some convention. They were like, what do you think about Marvel not letting DC call Captain Marvel Captain Marvel? And he's just like, come on, off it, give it back. Like, I'm like, yes, yes, exactly. You know.
Oh, I agree.
You notice in the new movie they did not call him Shazam, and there's a problem with that because you cannot call a superhero his trigger to turn into and back from a superhero.
Yeah,
you can't use that as his name. That's ridiculous. It'll be man, I don't know. You just can't because that's his keyword. That's supposed to be secret. So I don't know how they're gonna do it.
Well, yeah, to me, you know, it's such an old concept, too. You would think that would be, you know, like they couldn't take it away at this point. You know, you'd think that there would be some kind of, like, precedence.
Yeah.
That, like, even though there's another Captain Marvel, he still gets to be Captain Marvel.
They'd be like, look, we dig out comics from the 30s with him in it. So, like, you can't unname him.
But yeah.
They did it. It's stupid. Yeah, I think that's stupid. The dumbest thing in comics right now.
Yeah. Abe says this before it gets lost. I don't like Comic-Con because of the cost. Yeah, I agree with that. Way too expensive. And how big it keeps getting. You almost can't check out everything in one day, and food prices are worse than the theaters. Yeah, all three of those things suck.
They sell food there?
Yeah,
they sell anything that will drink. They might as well just put a vacuum cleaner in your wallet. Mm. Like, that's really what it's for. It's not for you to be entertained. It's for them to get your money.
To me, I went to, like, Stock Show, like, this year with my dad, you know. And we went into, like, the hall and shit, and they have, like, the Dodge trucks and the fucking fences and tractors and shit. And, like, you know, I was, like, walking down the aisle, and this, like, pretty girl comes up to me and, like, hands me a card. And, you know, she, like,
bought three tractors.
Exactly. Something like that. It's a real estate fucking scam. Oh, you know, you give me your email, we'll like we'll assign you for whatever. And I just thought, this is like what Comic-Con's like, you know? It's like, it's not about going and fucking, you know, finding the back issues you're missing from Fantastic Four. It's like, this is totally what Comic-Con's like. It's just a barrage of like, you know, mainstream media.
Yeah, exactly. It's just all marketing.
Yeah, it just sucks anymore, you know? and nobody can go anymore. It's like, well, all the artists are like excluded out. And that's about it. I mean, damn sure can't get any work.
Like, well, you're a comic artist. You can get into Comic-Con and be treated well. You just have to also star in a few movies. That's all. Just work on that.
Okay.
You know, action star / comic book guy.
Yeah, that'd be cool.
It's going to be a script.
What kind of movies are we talking about here?
Porno. That's the only movie to talk about.
That's kind of a low bar, but easy to do, sure.
Yeah. There you go. I got that joke there, low bar.
Preston Fulker, man, he's in there with the...
Wait. What are we talking about? Wait.
I was thinking more of an action movie. Like Jeff jumps out of a helicopter, machine gun, shoots a whole beach full of people, and goes Berserker Nuts is still on Indiegogo. Here you go.
There you go. Damn, I like that one.
Maybe I should work on that.
Got to win a helicopter, though.
Crystal says prices are insane. CB says they should do certain days at whatever Comic-Con that is actor / pop culture centric, and other days like comic book centric, thin the crowds out somehow. No, they should take all the actors and they should like push them off in the ocean.
Oh,
whoa. Wow.
And just say like, hey, this is a comic book convention. You do comics in the ocean if you don't.
In the ocean.
It's right there by the convention center.
Only Aquaman survives.
Yeah, they would be fine.
What about Aqualad?
So I like this one. Less Comic-Con and more. Oh, never mind.
Cleavage Con. Oh, yeah. There we go. Wiki bar. We're talking now.
People just want to see the actors and play video games. It's very expensive, too. Lots of guests. Everybody doesn't like the expense. Yeah, I agree.
Mm-hmm. I'm going to see the same amount of boobs at a titty bar for a little bit cheaper, I think.
Yeah, it's like, I don't know when the strippers came in to like, you know, I mean, they're cosplayers, but I mean, they're basically like cam girls, you know, like half of them. It's like, I'm not against them.
God bless them. Notice they're not letting like half of them be not attractive, you know, that says why, what they're there for, you know.
Yeah. Yeah.
There's no buck-tooth hairy people going wandering around Comic-Con. Not many, unless that's a costume.
Yeah. There's not enough diversity in comics. That's what you're saying.
It's not about boxes of comics anymore. It's about Flash and Hollywood.
There's not enough diversity in cosplay.
That's my complaint, actually. Is it just like, where's the fucking long boxes? I feel like we've been pushed out of our own hobby.
Yeah.
That sucks.
Let Hollywood in.
Yeah. And they're just going to be here till people get tired of the movies and they're going back to wherever they came from.
And sad thing is a lot of the local cons that like just the small local ones that are still almost like real cons like they used to be are trying to be more flashy and more like Comic-Con, you know. Yeah. So they're even trying to get rid of like the flea market feel of, hey, I'm just going to go and look at comics.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. We don't even really have like, I mean, they just all seem to be that way now, you know.
A lot of them don't even call them Comic Cons. They're just like entertainment conventions or something.
Yeah, like pop culture cons or something.
Yeah.
Yeah, there's one here that I keep wanting to go, but it keeps falling on the days I'm at church. But they'll have the Power Rangers come by and all that stuff. But
yeah.
I have to admit something.
What's that?
I fucking hate the Power Rangers.
Canceled Gib.
I'm sorry.
No, I'm with on that, man. I don't think much of that stuff either.
I guess I'm just a little too old for it, but I just didn't really dig it.
Does anybody really like the Power Rangers, though? I mean,
you got to be younger than us.
You got to be younger, yeah.
You like
Power Rangers come in. There was a lot.
I was not a big fan. I watched it to make fun of it, and then like, this is not bad.
People always make fun of the old cartoons where they say, oh, in this episode, we learned this and that and whatever at the end of a lot of stuff. Yeah. That's what was keeping people making cartoons here in North America and like our own stuff. And then as soon as that law changed where you didn't have to do that, they're like, wait a minute, we can like just buy like cheap crap from overseas and like commercials where you cut your hair with the vacuum cleaner and just fill that in. We'll make the same amount of money or more. And that was the end of Saturday morning. So I don't like Power Rangers because that's just the filler that came after Saturday morning was dying.
That is pretty much true, though. True. That was started like the beginning of that stuff.
Soon as that education law, they went, wait a minute, you know, we can get 400 pounds for 49 cents if we're buying Chinese cartoons. So
yeah,
or Japanese cartoons or whatever.
And Saturday morning, that's exactly where it went on TV. They went to like infomercials.
And people had the dream, like they had Cartoon Network in the States, and up here they had Teletoon, and it was going to be 24-hour cartoons, and people were like, oh, that's going to be amazing. But what you didn't think about is the people running the station are like, what kind of cheap crap can we get to fill this? Like, you know, they're making hot dogs, not gourmet meal. So it was like, and people were like, well, I don't really like the cartoons on this channel. And that became a substitution. So they closed down Saturday morning because they're like, oh, well, cartoons are on all the time. But then you look at it, and it's like, no, this is all junk, you know?
Yeah.
I don't know. That's just me. I'm from Saturday morning. I feel that stuff hard.
Yeah. No, like I remember when all that happened, too. They started showing, I think, Saved by the Bell. And
they started mixing in a lot of, like, all they had to pay for was the cast and the camera kind of shows, you know? A lot of that. Teen adventures or whatever. That was the start. And as soon as they started phase, because they were still had shows under contract to be made, you know, but they were changing. They're like, we don't have to make all this stuff. There's no more educational law. And it was I think it was a Ronald Reagan law. So Ronald Reagan is the real reason we had like the cool Saturday morning we had for 20 years.
Thanks, Ronald Reagan.
That's
Ronald Reagan. Ronald Reagan.
Well, there was something to that though, because it had something to do with the toys too. I think, wasn't it?
It was to protect kids. They were like, you can't just, you know, say buy cartoon, buy toys, buy candy, buy this, buy that, because that's kind of what the shows were. But yeah, they were like, you have to make this so the kids get something from it. And I think that made the whole magic of why people my age love it, because that's what we were when we were kids. But I think it made a certain quality that you can't like duplicate.
Yeah.
It was to sell stuff, but everything has to have a motivation. And, you know, they hired a lot of like super talented people to do it. So they were like, okay, here's the box we're working in. We're trying to sell these toys. Let's make something good to do it. That's all, you know.
Yeah.
It's way better than, you know, 49 cent that's Japanese cartoons.
That's why the Ninja Turtles was made into a cartoon show.
Oh, yeah. As soon as they discovered that they had that pipeline, as long as they made them, you know, some kind of educational, they could make a big, long cartoon featuring the toys that are in the local store, kids, you know?
Yeah.
People look down on that. That was the motivation that gave us an amazing Saturday morning. So I liked it.
Well, you know, He-Man was like the biggest one, though, where they basically, made the cartoon after the toy line.
Yeah, I think
That cartoon, because I remember when He-Man came out, the only story for He-Man was the little booklet came with it. He was just some barbarian. He lived in this like little hut, and he was, I think he wrestled Beastman the first one or something like that, but it had none of that other stuff. Like, yeah, they went to Filmation. Filmation made everything up that people know about He-Man.
Yeah.
Somewhere I have to dig them up, but somewhere I still have like – I had like some He-Man that came with like these little records, and I still have the records.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Floating around cool. somewhere. Yeah.
That's pretty neat. Were they like the cartoons and the records?
A little bit, yeah. The voices are different voice actors and stuff, but they were, I don't know, because they actually, I guess, were a little bit different. Yeah, they weren't exactly like that, because to be honest with you, that fucking, as much as I love that He-Man cartoon, it fucking sucks.
It's like the most limited animation, yeah.
Yeah, how many times can you use that damn running scene of fucking He-Man? You know what I'm saying?
Well,
like, come on, bro. You, like, throw that thing in three times an episode, every fucking episode.
It's no, like, more than 12 per episode, though, so I think that's pretty good quality control.
Yeah. But you know, man, it's like, holy crap, dude. He-Man was always running.
Let me read this comment. So, the first con I ever went to was held at a good sized conference center, all under one roof, costume judging in a small meeting room. It was nice. Made Steve Rude listen to my incoherent lies. And then CB says, mom activist groups destroyed Saturday morning and evening time cartoons. Yeah, maybe.
the original Whisper Network.
Yeah.
Moms everywhere. The Knitting Circle.
It's like the mom, you know, it's like the SJWs are like, they're like the young version of the moms. It's like the moms were trying to protect us from everything back in the 80s. And now it's just like young college girls with blue hair. Yeah. Trying to protect us from ourselves or something.
People are supposed to rebel against rules, not like leave and then go, hey, we need those rules we used to have. Like, no, like, you're supposed to grow out of rules.
Yeah, we need less rules. But better cartoons.
Exactly. Don't worry, I live a lawless lifestyle, guys. Oh, sorry. And better cartoons for sure.
Yeah.
Is it or not?
Yeah, that'd be a good one. That'd be great, yeah. Well, I was working on that, but then fucking Jeff said, hey, you know what you should do? You should get back on the comic.
You should make a comic.
That's what I think. I mean, you know. It's like season one premiering in 2025.
Yeah, well, that's about when this comic's coming out, too, so.
Good. This one,
I'm sure the sticker I'm working on is going to be printed on a material it's not invented yet. So yeah, things are going slow.
What sticker are you working on there, Creed?
Oh, I'm I have a group of fans in my I don't know, my Retromaniacs, I guess, the people that follow me, and I had a commission for Leader One from GoBots, and like, there's a lot of people that like want more GoBot stuff, and I already have Psykill in my 100 cartoon villains, but I was back when I was drawing them just portraits, so he doesn't have legs, so I gotta add legs to him. But when I went to go to add legs, I look at it, and I did this like 5 years ago, and stupid sloppy me didn't need it at 100% camera ready, so it's like sloppy, just like first pass inks. So I'm re-inking it.
Okay, cool. Yeah, I saw the Hercules one you put up. That's pretty cool.
Yeah, the Mighty Hercules. There's actually surprising amount of fans out there, and one of the very few times I get some Canadian orders, even though I'm in Canada. But yeah, Hercules is loved up here.
That's Canadian.
Yep, I am on the east coast of Canada on a magical island that like wins like tourist magazine stuff that beats out like Hawaii sometimes and whatever. Like yeah, we're everywhere I look is like a postcard. What? What were you saying, Frank?
You're near British Columbia?
Oh, no, I'm on the opposite side. I'm in Cape Breton.
Oh, okay.
I'm on the East Coast. It's still lobster season here.
So you're like way up there.
My character, the one I'm doing now, he's Canadian, and he's going to be based around British Columbia.
Right on. I hope he has lots of money, because I think a cardboard box is out of most people's price range in BC. It's expensive there.
Okay. Well, it's in the 50s.
Can't afford to be homeless, and is the kind of prices like.
Well, I'll move it to Toronto. Then.
Yeah. But yeah, I live right on the coast. Like, I can see the ocean out my window. Like, yeah, the coast.
Oh, okay.
So, like, you live like up above, like Maine or something?
Yeah. Like, if you just, I think there's actually. Like, Nova Scotia is two parts. There's a mainland and an island. I'm on the island. But I think the bottom of the mainland has a, like, a ferry or something that goes back to, I think it's Maine or yeah, somewhere down there. So, yeah, we're real close.
Okay. Yeah, my friend Sean, he grew up on an island out in, like, right around there, like, by Maine somewhere.
Ah, right on.
So it's probably, like, real close there. I can't remember what that island was called, though, now. It'll come to me in a little bit.
The Island of Misfit Toys.
Do what?
The Island of Misfit Toys.
Yeah.
There you go.
You pretty much it. The Misfit Cartoons anyway with me on it. But it's weird though. Like I draw what I draw, but like the art society or whatever around here is old women that paint like lighthouses on teapots. It's that kind of our culture. So there's yeah. No, that's the art culture here. I'll do side kill on a teapot. Maybe I'll fit in. I don't know.
There you go.
A lighthouse transformer.
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't know where the comic book, like, art culture is, but yeah, it's not here in Colorado either.
Yeah. Well, I see a lot of posers, people in shirts and stuff, and
telling how to Frank.
They know nothing.
Captain Courage has a crush poser. See, you just can't leave them alone.
Right. Captain Courage is on his way to the mall. Oh.
Captain Comics Gate.
Yeah. Captain Comics Gate. Uh-oh. Dark side. It has come. Canceled. Randy, what have you done? Sitting there all so quiet canceled. Like you didn't do this. Captain Comics Gate. All right, your evil plan has worked. Oh my god. It is on. Probably, you know, do it, dude.
Do it.
Get you like one of those Captain Chaos masks like Cecil wears and get on the show. But you gotta outdo him. You gotta outdo him because every time you come on, you gotta put your hands on your hips and go dun dun dun. Because that's what he did in the show.
And I think you should steal the Kool-Aid Man thing, too. You should only enter by smashing through a wall.
Going, oh, yeah.
You know, it's only drywall. Just use your knees, and you'll get through. No problem.
And the way you're going to get around this, dude, without like getting sued for trademark, is you're going to bust through the wall, say, oh, yeah, and then slap the first person you see. Pah!
Yeah.
Kool-Aid won't be able to sue you. You'll be A-OK. Get on that, Captain. We need that Captain Comics Gate.
All right.
Who just made that noise? Who just made that fucking noise?
It was me.
Oh, okay. That was
great. Oh, okay.
No, it wasn't me. I did.
What was it?
What noise was I didn't hear
it. It sounded like somebody was going to cry there for a second. Like,
yeah.
It's like because Randy's like, hearing his Comics Gate.
That's what the person Frank slaps is going to sound like.
Captain Comics Gate. Sway in.
So Jan's here. Jan says, funny how this around the same time in Europe, Saturday morning for kids got axed and became nothing but ads. Yeah, that sucks, man.
Yeah.
It was conspiracy, man. It's
worldwide conspiracy to cancel comics and cartoons and toys.
Yeah, I know.
It's made by all the people that used to bully us and call us nerds.
Yeah.
So fun.
Yeah, they're taking over con. You know, like all these fit people, all built bodies and stuff. They're taking over the cons, pushing the nerds out. The toys are turning into Funko Pops.
Yeah. And the I like my toys not to have hydrocephalus, you know, swollen brain syndrome or whatever it is. I like my toys not to have that.
Okay.
Like Rocky Dennis from Mask. It's like, how about if all your toys were like Rocky Dennis from Mask? I'm like, no, thanks, no. Well, we can bobble her head. Oh, no.
Stupid. Yep, Co-Pop toys looks like their mom drank while pregnant with them. Their heads are all swollen up. Their features are all swollen. Yeah.
The Berserker Nut Pop will be cool.
Whoa. I'm out of here. I can't handle this anymore. Oh, fucking Captain Comics Gate over here. Fucking.
What's the cheapest Funko Pop that we could buy? We'll just buy a bunch and repaint them. There you go.
Yeah. That's
what I think. Well, they're also different, though, Jeff. You can't just do that.
Oh, you can.
They sell blanks.
They have like a couple of little. Both.
Yeah. There you go. They're like the Wotko. They're basically the the toy version of the Vampirella cover right there. Just buy a bunch of them. Oh, cool. No?
That's why comics are getting nuts. I saw a post the other day from some guy, and he was just a comics fan. I follow a ton of comics people that talk about comics and not about all this junk, right? I just like to see about comics. My buddy was like, oh, Dynamite Comics, blah, 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 blah. So I guess I can't buy their book anymore, even though I'm the biggest Vampirella fan in the world. I'm like, you have the dumb. Like, just read your comic. It's not, everything's not a big protest, dude. Like, somebody doing something somewhere else that you don't like has nothing to do with you. Why are you even concerned with this? Don't you have a life? You know? I don't know. That's just me, though.
Yeah.
No, I agree. I think it's, like, stupid, you know?
It's kind of psychotic to say, like, oh, that guy has a different opinion from me. So I'm going to write his job and let them know all about it. I'm going to protest. I'm going to, like, review bomb his stuff into the ground. I'm going to do all this other stuff. Don't you have, like, a job or children to take care of, asshole? Like, what are you doing? Like, that's not normal. I don't know. And it's become the normal thing on the internet. It's crazy.
So yeah. I shouldn't have burnt all those Dynamite comics last night.
No, see, you started the whole thing, Jibrin. Jibrin, I don't know, man. Get a life, Jibrin.
Damn it.
Oh, man.
I messed up.
Of course, just me saying that is going to have somebody try to call my job, try to review about my stuff, try to, you know, that's what happens, too. It's crazy.
Yeah, I'm going to take down your Etsy.
I'm way too small to ever get canceled.
Yeah. It's, I think a lot of it, you know, at least some of the YouTube stuff anyway, is driven by views, actually. You know, these people build their channels on the views, and so, like, people start talking about Dynamite, they jump in on that.
Mm-hmm.
Like, let's get the views, just like I jumped in on Comic-Con tonight. Yeah. Not that I try to get some views, but just because, you know, I feel like being a smartass, but it's like,
Did you put hashtag Comic-Con at home?
Oh, yeah, man.
This show is going on in the exact same venue as Comic-Con this year. Like, we're basically a comic panel there.
We're on it. Yeah, we are. You say we are, and we are. Welcome to San Diego Comic-Con. You're talking to a bunch of legends.
Frank Salazar, creator of
Green Encouraging.
That's right.
Linchpin of Comics Gate, you know.
Creed Stonegate, creator of Underdog, and Randy Siplon, creator of Death Dealer.
Whoa. Damn, man. You can create a Death Dealer. I got to talk, dude. I know some of your paintings have been selling for like millions.
No.
It did, Randy did create a sweet-ass shirt, though. It's on Teespring.
Yeah.
And so did, I'm going to throw it in, the link in the description.
And so did Frank, actually. He's got some shirts up, I noticed today. Oh, we should go over to the Artcast. Are you going to go over there? Or
Frank's has it. Frank finally has his I Love Comicsgate shirts.
Because yeah, I love Comicsgate shirts, right? Captain Comicsgate coming soon.
You guys are going to keep that up. You guys are going to keep that up. You guys
coming with a lawsuit.
We're going to keep saying that until the Whisper Network mentions his name.
Yeah. The Whisper Network.
Yeah. And then we're going to scar it out. We'll be like, all right, see you tomorrow. Bye.
Tomorrow I'll log into Twitter and Gail Simone can't Slim Frank. I'm like, wow, what the hell?
That's right.
Like, damn, he's made it. Fucking Frank made it to the top. I'm fucking jealous.
I'll never work on this town again.
You can't cancel somebody that's fucking to nobody.
That's yeah, what you can't I, cancel. That's me. I'm bulletproof,
come on,
Gail. Man.
Come on. I got you. Got you.
Come at me.
I'm bulletproof. I have nothing to lose.
Come at me. Oh, my God. Dude, get the suit on. Captain Comic Cape. I'm just kidding. Correct.
I'm tempted to get the suit on.
Oh, my goodness. Make sure you turn the camera off, dude. We don't need to see nothing.
See, the only problem is aliens gave him that suit, and he used the powers and laid the book down right next to him, and then he used the powers again, and the book was gone.
Yeah, I can't find my book.
You're a great American hero, Frank.
I'm walking on air.
Yeah, I'm going to say, or you can do that every guy. Let's see here.
Let me look up more. I can just go. I think I have Facebook open. Let me just go over.
That's fine. Yeah, you can, dude. I was posting links in the chat. Sorry, I got all sidetracked.
I get it.
Oops.
Wow. Head butt through a microphone. What was that?
Yeah, there you go. He's done. Someone's not messing around anymore.
My head hit it.
Yeah.
He's got the screen like Kool-Aid.
Randy was slacking, and his wife came by behind him and slapped him in the back head.
Yeah. Get to work. Right. Come on.
Get that comic book money.
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah, get that comic book. Get controversial.
So Frank Salazar, there we go, posted, Robert Walker made and uploaded this video today. Check it out. Toxic Cancel Culture, Comic Book Karens. Whisper Network.
That's the video to me about.
This one looks like a fun one. Oh, and you're talking about some artist. Is this the artist you're talking about, or is it somebody else?
An artist was commenting on that video and commented where he had originally posted it.
Oh.
Bringing down Comicsgate, but I watched the video and it's like he's not really defending Comicsgate, he's just saying that he kind of like the SJWs are getting out of control, and he says I consider myself an SJW, and I think they are getting out of control.
Oh, nice!
But someone will comment in some about how Comicsgate is a hate group.
Yeah.
Like, okay.
The SJWs are calling.
So like, whatever. I'm gonna share this video. I don't care.
Got Xavier Gladney. Cool, I haven't seen him before. Like that. A cross-eyed monkey muscle man looks good. Yeah, it's cool.
There we go. Well, yeah.
That's great. Mark Rodriguez, more concept art for the sci-fi western comics, plus the pencils to the first three pages.
Oh, wow. That horse is awesome.
Yeah, that is a good horse. Cool.
And it's going to be a nice book.
Yeah, it looks really good.
Got Frank Salazar, Implementing Art Therapy for the Teens and the Support Group. Actually, I think I read this one yesterday. Mm-hmm. Buying some sketchbooks for the kids. That's very cool, man.
Making the rest of us look like slack ass shit.
Yeah, I know. Right. Wow.
You know, he's out doing real stuff, helping people.
That's right. What do we do with our lives?
Scribbling on paper and waiting to see if somebody smiles at it.
Yeah, running my fucking mouth.
Yeah.
And then this video I watched, and it's pretty cool. It's fan art for Captain Courage.
And that's cool.
He's got a whole bunch of it when you watch this video. It's really good stuff.
Yeah, and that's on the Captain Courage channel, so I'm wearing the helmet and the shirt. I didn't want to put on the whole suit.
Yeah. I'm gonna throw the link in the chat. People can go check it out. Looks like Adam Lore is here.
Oh, cool. Adam.
This is Adam.
He's doing the 100 days too.
The light. Oh, is he? He's still in the 100 Days of Comics right now? Cool.
Yeah, he just started, I think he's on day 6 or 7.
Great. Good job. So we got some Elijah art. Some practice studies. Yeah. Working hard, learning. Good job, man.
Digging it.
Cat head there.
That cat head crazy, dude. What's going on there? I think that cat looks drunk, sir. Is that cat on the lean?
Oh, Adam says he's on day 9. Well, cool, man.
Hell yeah, keep rocking.
Oh, day 9. I'm sorry, Adam.
Hang in there, dude. So we've seen that yesterday. There's Josh's propaganda.
He's even cloned himself to spread it around. I saw something.
Oh, did he?
There's a new prank shirt.
He's got a crew of 12 Joshes working on that album.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. I saw that video, too.
Oh, yeah. That was funny, yeah.
He's cloning himself in the basement.
Send himself for pizza.
I'd like that as well. They could get up early to do my time. But that looks great, dude. That's over on Teespring. Links in the Artcasters Facebook group. Got some more Constantinos Patelios art.
Yeah.
DC's Wildcat. Let's see who this is.
Cool.
Yeah, good job, man.
DC's Wildcat.
See, Nora Marie Black, her back. Looks like she's got a new video up, I guess, on a sketchbook tour. I used to watch her videos. They're pretty good. And
there we go.
Adam Wolf, freaking up the spaceships, sticker. So that's it for today. Good job, guys.
I guess there's still a banner happening, huh? Or is that not going on no more? We didn't get enough people.
Is there what?
The banner. You were going to change the banner on the Archivist. Mm-hmm. Is that still happening?
It is. I just got to save it and put it up early. So okay. That's good that you're reminding me. I should write myself a note. Mm-hmm. It's just been sitting there.
Yeah, so I guess now I need to send you something.
Finish banner. Oh, yeah. Well, you could send me something more. I just got some stuff on the phone.
Oh, okay. Well, if you did, that's fine. That's fine.
I figured you can't tell me no, so.
No, Jeff. Yeah, everybody heard it, too. No.
Wow.
Copyright.
Somebody's like, wow.
That was me.
Since you guys follow Comicsgate, actually, Did you guys hear?
I don't follow Comicsgate.
You don't?
I follow Randy. Whatever Randy says.
I know. It yeah. seems to be like just watching Randy is why Comicsgate constantly gets come up on the show. But
sure, I like blaming Randy for that at least.
Yeah. Sorry. What were you gonna say, Jeff?
Sorry. Well, yeah. I just kind of had to slide back my chair so I need to grab a picture so I got some reference. But do you guys watch any of that like the anti-Comicsgate group, the Preston Poulter guy, and all that?
Yeah, a little here and there.
Because there's some meltdown shit happening over there. So somebody
will be soon.
Somebody told me about this zombie guy who was like a some kind of scammer guy that put up some site to selling tickets to space or something.
Yeah, I heard about this.
Right. So that
you
that
mean actually, that's a scam? Oh,
yeah.
Shit.
I hope you didn't buy one.
You know, so, unpack.
Yeah. Anyway, he was on this panel. I mean, basically, they've made this pre-wiki, which we did actually talk about this on the show. We did that when Keith Barnum was on. We were talking about where people can post their work, and, you know, they got their little community of people over there.
Oh, yeah.
Hiring people and stuff like that. So, but anyway, this wiki thing that they got going with all the people on it, there's this guy, his name is Zombie. And he, I guess he hijacked that thing away from that Preston Poulter guy. So he like nefariously took control of it and booted out the dude who made it, which I guess was that Preston Poulter. And now he's like trying to get it back some way, and he wants his stuff out of there. But now they've all loaded onto this, site where everybody can use each other's characters. And it's kind of funny, man. It's like all kinds of dramas happening there. And I don't know. I'm watching to see how it all shakes out. But I just thought it was kind of crazy to do that anyway. Like, let you, you know, they were talking about how to be like this great idea. But then I kept thinking, like, I don't know if I want people, you know, taking the berserk or not and just writing whatever they want. And, you know, and I guess it's didn't turn out to be such a good idea now that somebody's got a hold of his stuff where he doesn't have any control anymore.
But how do you lose that?
Well, I guess the site, somebody made the site, and then they were all admins, and then as an admin, he kicked out the other admin and took control of it, I guess. I mean, that's my layman's.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Oh. So it's the plan I have for this show in the Orcast.
Captain
Urge
was
going to
do to them.
Exactly. Yeah, Captain Comicsgate was going to take the show.
Damn it.
The alter ego of Captain Courage.
Yeah.
Corrupt.
This is some funny shit that I saw happening.
What?
This is some funny shit that I saw happening recently, you know.
Mm-hmm. I'm gonna have to go watch some of that, dude. I'm down now. I want to hear him complain.
It's hard to follow, though. You know, it's like I don't know. I wasn't even like on the like one of their sites. I heard this on like a different show. You know what I mean? And then they kind of mentioned it in like a real small way on their own show. So I'm like, oh, that's what the hell they were talking about, you know.
So, I mean, I thought he's kind of making it sound also Preston Poulter. I thought a little bit like him and his lawyer kind of gearing up, I guess, for some sort of legal battle with EVS or something.
I noticed he likes that. He likes to drop little. You know, whatever hints that like he has a lawyer and he's gonna drag somebody into court, but I don't know what's he waiting for. Do it then, you know.
Anybody can get a lawyer.
What's it, yeah, that's right.
Waiting for the mom's allowance to drop.
That's very true. Just because you're saying it doesn't mean a judge is going to say it.
Oh, yeah. So. That was a case, man. You know how innocent I would have been?
I was with Frank all day reading to blind kids. That's where I was, Your Honor.
Hell yeah.
Well, what's he? I wonder what he's going to sue. I mean, is he talking about suing EBS because, like, they found his porn online or something?
I don't know. I don't know if that's his revenge porn or whatever. If that's what he calls it. It's like, but here's my thing with that revenge porn shit. It's like, how is it like EBS? It's like, well, if EBS didn't put it online, and if he didn't like film this or anything, how is it like he did revenge porn on him? It's like that doesn't even make sense to me. It's like it sounds like he willingly put it up and people found it.
Yeah, it was like online and people found it, and I don't understand.
Discovered like, porn. That's not revenge porn. That's like, hey, look, porn.
Well, I was going to say, and I thought it was kind of funny because, like, for all his, like, touting about this revenge porn and stuff like that, I noticed, like, they all on that Anti-Comicsgate channel had all kinds of fun, making fun of, like, Donald DeLay and his, like, three-way weirdo marriage or whatever. You know, because they were all like, oh, he's kink-shaming me and all this shit. Well, aren't they, like, kink-shaming Donald DeLay now?
Yeah.
You know? They're all fucking guilty.
That's right. Yeah. Burn them all. Burn them all, Jeff.
Yeah.
How dare you? How dare you?
Crystal says, beginning a new cult born from a scam.
Ooh.
That's what she says.
Mm-hmm. She's talking about Comicsgate?
She's talking about Anti-Comicsgate now splitting into two factions, I think. I don't know. It's just something to watch, really.
Hell yeah.
Not that I really care, but I find it kind of funny.
It's kind of a silly line. Like, everybody wants to make comics, and then they're like, well, some people don't want all the characters to have a sex change or whatever. Like, just don't want a lot of that's they just want to read comics, and then the other half does. Well, okay, where's the war? And then they just start a war over. Like, that's not something to argue over. You like different comics than me. It's not something to argue over. I don't know. That's just my opinion. I don't know.
Well,
I don't even make comics, so don't listen to me on anything. But you know,
what that is like?
I'm joining Sticker Gate.
Yeah, you starting Sticker Gate, right? You start that, dude.
Make stickers great again.
I think one of the things that brought Comicsgate about was that, but it was also when people would be vocal about it on social media, mainstream.
They'd say, "Oh, you're Hitler for bringing something up."
Exactly. That's the that's where you know the problem came.
Yeah,
because that's ridiculous. If you can't criticize something, or you're a monster. No thanks. That's not how things work. You can criticize anything, you know.
Yeah. And I think that your point about that, you know, like you like different comics than me is like a pretty valid one. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
What's
to argue about, you know? Yeah. And I'm sure two people on either side that they're in big war and typing all this garbage back and forth and whatever else, I'm sure they love some of the same books if they're really into comics, you know.
Yeah. Right.
Some, you know, there got to be one. Somebody go, well, there was this Archie, and somebody go, oh, I'm a big Jughead fan. There they go. They got a conversation already. You know, that's, I don't know. But people want to focus on the difference. You're the devil and I'm an angel. And the other side's like, no, we're the angel. You're the devil.
Yeah.
You're all the devil.
That's right. Let's all be the devil. It's more fun.
The white devil.
Oh, jeez.
How dare you say that, Frank?
And I'm the only Mexican on here, so.
Well, it makes it up.
I'm the token Mexican.
Then we have the token Canadian, eh?
Yeah, I'm glad you got the accent.
Yeah, what is this, NAFTA?
Yeah, exactly. How we pulled out
hands across the world, but don't actually touch my hand. Stay 6 feet apart.
And how dare you, Randy, while I'm thinking about it, put up a picture of dead Bigfoot dying of the COVID?
Sorry. I don't think it's 100% authentic.
Are you sure? Okay.
Yeah, I went to click that, and it was like, it was just a picture. I thought you were sending me to an article, dude.
Yeah, ready to read that shit. Well, I called the National Enquirer. They said they didn't know nothing about it. And if they don't know anything about it, I think it's right.
I think that thing was, I've seen that picture before, though. I think that was actually from something else. Somebody just made that later. Yeah.
They're like, Jibrin, we couldn't figure that out, but we do have a picture of Elvis mutilating cows, so that's something.
Yeah, there we go. I need that picture. I need to see that.
Using the chainsaw. It's just gory. It's just gory.
Yeah. A hunk of burning brisket.
When you're Elvis, they don't stop you. You know, you can do what you
want. Oh, no, they don't, man. That'd make a great animation, by the way.
Oh, yeah. Just Elvis mutilating cows. He'll mutilate one, then he'll look over to two gray aliens and look, is it all right? Yeah. And they'll give him the thumbs up, and he'll mutilate another one. There we go.
He'll mutilate it, look over, and be like, thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you. And they'll be like, thumb him up, and get another one.
That's what this show needs, more cattle mutilations.
Yeah, there you go. Now we
yeah, you don't hear that much about those anymore around here. They used to be big time, you know, back in the 70s.
Those aliens left, dude. Those aliens left. They went to another star system.
That could be.
Who's got the butt probing ones nowadays?
Yeah. Please be the mutilation kind, is what I'm saying.
Yeah, really.
So they want to mutilate your butthole.
I think the craziness people used to have about aliens, now they just have about everything. And that's just how it is now. That's why you don't hear about aliens. They're busy. It's everything now.
That is true.
It's the monstrous parents that gave their child a gender. You know, there's stuff like that going on. Forget aliens.
Yeah.
How dare they? I better shut up. I'm getting canceled.
Welcome to the club.
Yeah. And sticker gate begins.
That's right.
Well, the only one canceled so far has been Randy.
Yeah.
So, and I agree with that.
We like to keep it that way.
He's just canceled, but they might do a spinoff.
Yeah.
Yeah.
They're waiting for his next post.
Like Gibbs said, you have to be somebody to be canceled. I mean,
yeah.
Yeah.
Yes.
What are you talking about, man? I saw EBS show up and give the blessing. It's on.
Well, that's true. He did give me a shout out on one of his videos the other night too. So.
There it is.
Darkcast.
No.
EVS.
Dark
Comics and Pro Secrets.
Yeah.
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 You know.
Yeah, I'm subscribed to him, and I didn't know who he was.
Really?
Yeah, because he was doing, I was looking up sketch cards and tips, and I found one of his videos. Like, oh, this is cool. I'm going to subscribe. And then I found out that's Ethan Van Sciver.
Yeah, that's the devil.
Yeah, so did you subscribe then, Frank, or did you?
I'm subscribed.
Oh, did you?
Oh, yeah, I didn't know who he was at first. I just thought he was some guy that did sketch cards.
Nah, he's like a comic book artist. I don't think he does cards.
He's in Rainbow Brute. He's like, oh, that looks cool. Check it out.
Yeah. That's like a book he's going to do or something, I think.
Rainbow Brute. Oh, man.
So, you know, Randy, when you think... Right.
What?
When you do your book, Randy, are you gonna do like a longer book? Like a lot of these guys are doing and charge more, or are you gonna do like a shorter book? Like, have you thought about that?
Yeah, you know? I mean, I've thought about it. I mean, I was thinking of doing like just a like regular 32 page comic, and then have like stretch goals to increase like the page numbers. Because like I'm doing all the like stories kind of in chapters, so like I can always like add, you know, more to it if I want. So
yeah,
it's not just like one ongoing, you know, story.
Yeah.
Okay, like an anthology kind of like little side stories.
Well, it's not an anthology though, because it's all the same character. But like, if there's gonna be like, you know, there like every. Maybe like 12 pages, it's going to be like a chapter break where it goes to like a different, you know, scene or something like that.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, I'm going to start it out, you know, smaller and see if I can, and do like a stretch goal thing to, you know, and add pages, and then maybe, like I want to just do it as a comic, like set, you know, with staples, like saddle stitch. Yeah. But I might do a thing where have like a stretch goal where it becomes like a perfect bound or something like that. I haven't figured it all yet. But.
Yeah. Well, I was just kind of wondering because I've been thinking a lot about that, the pricing, and you know, I'm always kind of like with this pricing conundrum, like anything I ever think about it. Cause I still feel like, you know, I want to be able to compete in comic shops if I can get in there eventually.
Right.
And, you know, that doesn't seem to like, you know, jive with the current,
no,
at least the current state of things on Indiegogo and stuff. You know?
Yeah. I mean, like I mean, a lot of people recommend having like $25 be like your lowest price point, but I think that's kind of high. I don't know.
Yeah, that seems to be the way a lot of the bigger ones are doing it too.
Yeah. The thought though behind it is that you'll get more than just a comic. You'll get like a trading card and a print or something like that too. Mm-hmm. But then you got to worry about like shipping and stuff too.
Absolutely. Yeah.
Yeah.
I like what his name, Zay, that was on last night or the other night. Mm-hmm. That he was doing paper dolls and paper masks. I like that idea.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's cool.
I was like, oh, I can do that with Captain Courage. Because actually, I have some old paper dolls of myself that I made. Like, I can just turn that into Captain Courage.
Yep,
cool. And I do like that idea a lot, adding stuff in.
Mm-hmm. You know, because that's another thing is that, you know, like, what do you, like, coming up with what you're actually going to, like, sell, and then also, like, what kind, if you want to have, like, some sort of stretch goals that open up in the campaign, you know? Oh.
Yeah, I mean, but stretch goals, it's just, like, those are great, but it's like that doesn't affect the price that you're at. All that affects is like how many, you know, how many people you have. And if you don't, if you're not getting a lot of people, I don't feel like the stretch goal thing is you know what I mean? It's like you gotta like, you know, pretty much have that settled before you start.
But I think the reason a lot of people, especially like the bigger, you know, crowdfunded stuff, the reason they do it is they're hoping that the people that have already backed it will like promote it through social media and try to get other people to back it to increase the amount to get, you know, more, to get it higher. Mm-hmm. So that the stretch goal,
they get more stuff out of it. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. And that makes sense.
Yeah.
Now, Randy, are you going to put your book in Walmart and screw the your backers, or?
Yeah, I'm just going to take stacks of my book and just put it on the shelf in Walmart.
That'd be cool.
I think that would be the only way I'd get it in there.
Just go in there every fucking day.
Yeah.
Underwear off the what's called shelf. Put your comics there.
Just push the rhetoric, push the comics over. Put your comics down.
Civil disobedience right there. That's what we should all be fucking doing. So our
get
fucking
there and shake up some squares.
Yeah. Which I still have not seen the stupid Red Rooster books and stuff in Walmart.
There's already one book too.
Just keep like laughing at me, but it's like they just don't stock them at my Walmart, man. It's lame.
They've been having issues with it. Like the second
one, Scott Circling was having trouble getting it.
Yeah.
Oh, really? What did Scott think of them? Did he get them and review them or anything?
Well, he wasn't able to get them. He didn't find them.
Oh, really?
He was asking Ronnie because Ronnie works at Walmart. So he was asking him, like, on his store, where would they be? And he was, I don't know if he ever got them. He wanted to check them out, but I don't know if he ever got any.
Yeah.
I'd be pretty angry if I backed a book over Kickstarter or wherever, and then all of a sudden, buddy got a deal and he's selling it somewhere else, and I still did, and there's none in my hand. I'd be.
Yeah, it was a dirty move, I think. Yeah, he should have fucking not done that.
You know that YouTuber, Draw and Talk?
Who that guy is. He's got, he like, I can't remember what his name is, like black hair.
It's Tyler or something. I joined his Discord, so he'll talk about the Red Rooster. Yeah, he went by Walmart because he backed the book, and he still hasn't gotten it. So he showed a picture where, and I think he might put it on Twitter or something, but stacks of Red Rooster, and he's just like flipping it off because he still hasn't gotten the book.
Not cool.
He's like, where do you go to? There's stacks of Red Rooster.
Like, I can see taking that deal. That's no problem, but take care of your people that just took care of you first.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah,
that's a moment of integrity. That's like, I could do this now, or I can tell these people, I can't do that right now. How about a little while when I take care of this other stuff?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
But he just went, oh, hey, that's fantastic. Money, money, money.
Well, I just don't understand, you know. Like, I get that sort of, but then, like, you know, the books are there. Like, whether the Walmart ones or whatever, it's like, the fucking books are printed. All you had to do is just, like, start mailing those things, you know. Get them out before they hit their shops.
Yeah, but, just, yeah.
Just, you know, I know people were like, I know people were like, oh, it's going to be a nicer book. And, you know, I don't know. But to me, just get them something, man. I don't think people would have been so mad if they just got something.
If they'd have just got book one before it hit the shelves in Walmart, I think they'd have probably been pretty been a, you know, a little okay and a little more understanding.
Yeah.
And you kind of explained yourself, like, hey, look, this is what's happening. I thought, I know y'all bought the trade paperback. I got this deal with Walmart. I'm trying to do that. I'm going to, instead of getting the trade paperback, would you take, you know, the four floppies? I can get you those now.
Yeah.
Maybe try to work something out. Try to work something out.
Isn't it just the two, though? I don't even think it's four.
Oh, is it? I don't know.
It's like a two-issue thing, I might be wrong.
I think it might be three.
Oh, three, okay.
I love when somebody asked him, and he basically what he said is, oh, we're super, super, super busy. Mm-hmm. Well, yeah. Not too busy to take people's money.
Yeah.
That's, you know.
At the end of the day, it's how he's going to run his business, and it's going to, you know, probably hurt him a little bit in the long run.
I wonder what the deal is, yeah, with those books, though. Like, are they going to consistently, like, come out? You know what I mean? Is this just like a for a short run type situation, or are they going to be like coming out like the DC comics? Because the DC comics are still coming out in Walmart, you know?
It seems so, like that's their new, like, we're a comic company and this is how we're going to do it. But in 5 years, you'll have to look up the name of that because that's not going to be anything.
Right, right. I kind of feel that way too. I think it's going to bomb, but. And honestly, I just feel like it's, you know, I don't want to brag, but I just kind of, I don't know, you know, it's, I think you got to like, you got to do something that people really are going to, it's going to get people's attention. I just don't know if those are it. That makes me sound like a dick, but. So Elijah says, do you have any message to you? What should I draw?
Man, you always put me on the spot with that, man. I'm drawing skulls, so why not draw some skulls?
And I should draw Berserk or not, Doom Barbarian, and Captain Courage.
Doing pickups.
On a stagecoach.
Hanging up. Yeah.
Delivering
the mail. There you go. Fighting, fighting off some would-be outlaws on a stagecoach.
There you go. I like that. Elijah is like, fuck this show.
No question's a stupid question, Elijah. Always ask. I'll just say no.
That's like, that is the classic fucking commission. Right there. Yeah. You know what I mean? It is always something like that. And then, like, out the window, I want you to draw the moon. And then on the moon's surface, there's like a circus. And then one guy at the circus is eating cotton candy. You're like, dude, like, I can't fucking like physically draw that.
Yeah. He's covered in thousands of microscopic nanobots. How are you going to draw that, by the way?
Oh, wait a minute. Can you draw him to look like me and have all my tattoos on him?
There's this thing called perspective. You're breaking all the fucking rules of it right now. Yeah.
You go. That's when you say, I can't do that. He's like, well, I thought you were good.
Yeah.
Man, I thought you were good. You can't do it, dude. I'll find someone else that can.
Yeah, what do you guys...
Straight to Fiverr.
Fiverr, yeah. I should get on Fiverr. I need $5 today.
Hell yeah.
You need one of those screens you've been making, one with Scott Circling turning red and steam coming at his ears every time somebody says Fiverr.
Oh man. I write that down. Fiverr alarm.
Yeah. Fiverr alert.
Then I have to get Scott on the show for the whatever the premiere.
The screen grab you're gonna use.
Yeah. Wait, on the show, he's probably get one off that he's already had.
Well no, I know, but I want him to be on the show the first time I play it.
Though. Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Definitely.
You could just mention Fiverr and just play a clip of him actually having steam coming at his ears.
I go to one of his videos, though, and, like, capture him saying it, though. Like, Fiverr!
Well, there's a video he did where he says Fiverr sucks.
There, oh boy!
There we go.
I'll be using you later, Frank, to hunt that down.
Such a heartless bastard, man. That's Scott Circle. Huh? Such a heartless bastard. No, I mean, yeah, it's, I don't know why he hates Fiverr. It's kind of funny. He hates Fiverr as bad as I like hate like print on demand, like print shops and stuff like that. So you thought we used to talk about those, and he'd be like, "Ah, oh, jobs, that's so bad. Pocket money."
I hate Comic Con.
Yeah. Well, I'm kind of over that already. But let's see. Maybe we should switch this up. Let's go.
What?
Let's go to this here. Oh,
there you go, Creed. That one's for you.
God bless America.
There we go.
Yeah.
Seems like he's trading.
Does anybody want to watch Mike's birthday video? I got that here too.
Mike's birthday video? Yeah, it's going to get destroyed.
That was good while it lasted. I can't play that. Crystal's in there. Well, like, slap me in the face if I had to Colorado.
All right.
Okay, no. You're not actually going to try it, dude. So he says, Elijah says, could you repeat the details, though? Or I got Captain Courage, the Berserker Knot, and the Barbarian in a Stagecoach.
Fighting it off, like fighting off a bunch of would-be outlaws trying to take over the Stagecoach.
And they're all Wookiees.
Whoa.
Whoa. Outlaw Wookiees trying to jump you. Mm-hmm. Happens all the time.
Oh, man.
And Midge Guyver is there.
There's a week's worth of drawing right there.
Yeah,
that is brutal. That's kind of, I just feel like that's just not right. That's good.
You don't have to do it, Elijah. We're just messing around.
No, we need it for the thumbnail of this video. So, you know, take your time, but TikTok.
Top, top.
Super deep.
Yeah.
Right now.
If you do, which I don't know if this is much of a reward, but if you do too, try that, Elijah, I'll definitely make it a thumbnail of whatever video we show. I don't know if that'll get you anything. But...
Elijah needs to be on.
Yeah, he's going to be a guest. If you want to come on, Elijah, send me a message on the. Or you could just jump in if you want, but it's almost over. Just send me a message on Facebook or something. I'll be on sometime. I wonder what Mike Hoffman's Kickstarter is doing. Oh, I just noticed it on Facebook here. Mm-hmm. Let's take a look.
Do it, dude. I got something crazy about Mike Hoffman today. Nothing gets too crazy, but...
Four days to go, and he's up to $1,000 finally.
24 backers. Yeah. Looks cool, man. And how much has he won for, like, for the actual book? I know we went over that last time, but
I think it was.
Was it like $20 maybe?
Yeah, look at how. I mean, this is what drives me crazy. I'm going to complain about Kickstarter for a minute. It's like this thing. Why does it do that? It's like, I want to see it.
Read that. What's it?
I can't see it. No, it's not there.
That's really dumb. That's roll over super, that hides it. That's
super annoying.
Yeah.
Yeah. And then it says select this reward. So even if you just want to read it, you're like, wow, I want to select it. So anyway, so let's see. Pledge $20 and get the card set. The soft cover is $25.
$25, yeah. It's, man, it's awesome. Love his work.
$31 for shipping for me. Colorado. For you, Creed, it'd probably be fucking $50.
$174,000.
You know damn well that wouldn't
American. At a 30-some percent exchange.
It's so wrong, man. They're like running businesses out of business with that, these shipping prices. Oh, yeah. Not right.
I read somewhere that it was they changed, like, let's say they were all in the certain club for the mailing, whatever. Then I heard like the states like unjoined whatever mailing system that was, and that's what's causing all the rift.
Really?
I read that somewhere. So if they knew what they're talking about, I do.
Yeah.
But it kind of makes sense, though, because it was all of a sudden, like, you know.
Yeah, because I remember back when I was mailing sketch cards. So, I mean, that's only probably 8 or 9 years ago. And it wasn't unbelievable, you know. It was like you could mail stuff to, like, you know, Germany and stuff, or like
it was just like another few bucks. It wasn't like something ridiculous. Yeah.
And now it's like freaking $25, you know.
Yep, which is crazy.
Because I used to sell like so many prints overseas, and now, like, I mean, should I never sell a print overseas? Nobody wants to pay more than the print to get the damn thing over there.
Yeah.
So.
Even if you love the thing, if you end up paying double, in your gut, you're just going to be like, oh, that's not, you don't want a customer to have a shitty feeling.
Yeah, I know. Yeah, you want people to get what they want fast and, you know, preferably cheap. I used to actually do free shipping when I first started selling sketch cards, and I could actually do that, you know.
Yeah.
Not anymore. It's too risky, man.
It wouldn't make a cent.
Yeah, I mean, that you know, those international guys would just wipe you out. Every time you got one of those orders, man, it'd take, what if you made off of 3-4 orders to just ship that one?
Speaking of Mike Hoffman, dude, I was trying to bid on a piece he had up tonight.
Oh, really?
Painting up, yeah, dude. He had a painting up, and when I saw it, I think it was at $41. Yeah, I'm gonna pull it up right now. It was at $41, and it's up. It's like a little different than what he normally does. But you had really good contrast to the painting. And what was I gonna say? My wife was basically like, as long as you can get it, you know, for try to keep, you know, don't spend over $100 for it. And I was like, because it was at $41, like, holy crap, man. And let me share my screen. This thing ended out.
Hold on. Where's your screen at?
There we go. This thing ended out at $111, dude.
Yeah. He's always do that. He usually starts at like a buck or something, like some crazy little price. They shoot up. Yeah, I was looking at that one, I think on Facebook.
Yeah.
What do you call it? Like something Road Warrior or something Driver?
Night. It's called Dark Knight Driver.
Yeah.
Something like that.
It's unusual. Yeah. It looks different than his usual stuff.
Yeah, I tried to buy that one. And then the other one we were looking at, but I don't know. I'm cheap, man. I didn't want to. It was starting at 100, and it was a little more than I really wanted to spend. But I thought this one was, is it gone? It went away. I guess, I don't know what happened there. No, I can't look at it. I guess not, but it was this cool Jesus, like, in the UFOs. It was like these UFOs in the background and Jesus standing in front of it.
That's usually up on his
it doesn't have the aliens on it, though. It's an actual painting, a new painting he did, where it's just Jesus and there's like these UFO saucers behind it. I wonder if it went back up.
Oh, okay.
But let me go. I'm gonna see if he reposted that thing or something, or if he's going to.
He better watch out for copyright. The Pope doesn't like people using his characters.
Yeah.
His character.
Oh, man.
Yeah.
Struck down by the Pope.
Later, right. Frank. It was great to have you on the show.
All right, Frank.
I don't see it back there.
He's got a freaking ton of stuff up now. I'm just going through his eBay. I mean, I haven't seen him have this much stuff up in a long time. He's got like how many pages?
Three.
Oh, three? Is that all?
Am I wrong?
I got nine here.
Okay, I'm liar. Yeah.
I searched his name, so it's probably other people selling old stuff and everything. Yeah.
So. Got to go to Hoffman International Airport.
Yeah, that's right. Greatest store name ever.
Yeah, you know, maybe you can fly into Hoffman International and catch.
Oh yeah, this is that one painting with the aliens.
Yeah, not the one. And there was another one though, but it's not up. I guess it didn't sell. He hadn't put it back up. I love those paintings. I want to put that painting in my bathroom, dude. I want to get one frame and put it in my bath. It's like a perfect bathroom painting, dude.
Definitely a bathroom painting.
Awesome. He's blessing the little gray aliens.
Yep.
All the little children of the world.
So Elijah said, I'd love to come on once I have something to promote. All right, dude. Hold you to it.
Sure.
So what did she say? They still have the first issue out, too. What
that was. Red Rooster.
Oh, right. It's probably still in demand, like an Indiegogo.
It's in demand. You can still pick up the trade.
That was one thing I was listening to when I was listening to those anti-comic skate guys argue over who owns, you know, these characters they're all sharing. But they were talking about, like, just everybody in Comicsgate, you know, they're like, and then they put their books, they fund their books for whatever, and then they put their books, in demand, and then they take, like, 6 months to draw the thing, and so it sits in demand, like, and, you know, just gets more money, you know, like it's some kind of scam.
Terrible.
To just sell your comic, and then they're like, and then they just leave it in demand after they fulfill, and I was just like, well, what the fuck? Don't you want to make money? The fuck is wrong with that? I know.
So let me get this straight. They're selling their art and creation to other people? The nerve. Yeah.
Hold on.
The
nerve. I got a question. So what is this thing that you call profit?
Yeah.
Exactly.
Explain this, like, profit thing to me.
That's one thing I don't like, you know, is like, I get when people complain about Comicsgate when they're like, you know, going after somebody or something, but it's like the success though and stuff that I'm like, awesome. You know, that's great. Yeah. The more comics that sell and crowdfund and stuff that honestly does help all of us.
Yeah.
You know, and, you know, hopefully everybody fulfills and keeps their promises, because that kind of hurts us when they don't. But, you know, I'm all for, like, yeah, let's see the $2 million books next, you know? That's what I want to see. Hopefully mine's one of them.
Everybody needs food and shelter, so why get on somebody for making money?
I get $2 million, I'm buying everybody in this panel a, I was going to say a house, but I'll buy you guys a milkshake.
I get $2 million, I'm paying somebody to beat everybody in my town.
We'll be the milkshake boys.
We'll all do the ArtCast live every night. We'll fly you guys out every night.
Ding dong. Who's there? Goons. Hired goons.
Yeah. There you go. Oh, yeah.
When's Josh coming on?
Josh Kimball?
Never.
Yeah. Never.
I just realized I better say that was a joke. I do not plan to beat anybody, just in case the RCMP is racing to my house.
Yeah.
The age we're living in. It's ridiculous.
No, I'd have Josh on. I don't have nothing.
Which Josh, though? You want to have the one with the guitar, or the other guy that was there, or whoever's free at the time, I guess.
Josh number three.
Josh 3.0.
Cool.
Just tell him, we want Josh number three, but don't dare bring Josh number two. We don't like that guy at all.
Yeah. He's a little rippy.
I don't know. I know that Josh is doing the beyond his album or whatever. Mm-hmm. It's like, I know he's got the literary agent or whatever thing going with his book, yeah, where he hasn't got his book yet, because it's like literary agent and it's out there. And I know, like, when I was talking to him before on some show, I was kind of like, don't even do any excuses or whatever. Make sure you get the book out. And so not that he wouldn't come on, but you know what I mean, though. It's like, I hope he's not doing that, though. Just putting it off with the literary agent so he doesn't have to put it out, you know. So I almost feel like I don't want to invite him on, because it's like, eventually we'd have to talk about that. not that, you know, I'm calling him.
Get that sorts out, then have him on.
Yeah, exactly. It's just literally he's doing his book, and then. But I'd have him on. I don't know. And then I saw you over there commenting on Mike's comment where he was like saying he'd come on and he's not anti 100s or whatever. I guess, you know, I guess we'll throw that out there too.
Oh, that's a new thing. There's 100s and anti-100s.
Anti-100s, which I didn't leave a comment back, but I was going to just say, I was going to invite him on, but then I was kind of like, well, shoot, now then doesn't that just add to it? You know what I mean? It's just going to. Then we have to have a conversation about why he left, and I have to be on one side or the other about Kevin, which I'm not really on need. You know, I'm not on one side or the other, but it seems like I'm going to have an opinion.
Yeah.
So I either have to go like, yeah, it's cool, or no, it's not. And I'm not either way.
So, isn't it really up to each individual, like whatever they had it? Like, it's not a blanket thing. You know, I have friends that left and I have friends that stayed.
Yeah.
I told the friends that left, I'm like, call yourself the 99. Just, I'm being funny, but I mean, you know, whatever. I don't care. But it's everybody is doing their thing that fits them. That's all it is.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. So anyway, I didn't know what to really respond. So I just left it. But I'm not against Mike. I'm not like not friends with him, you know.
Yeah.
Not against having him on. I'm not like, you know, like, oh, those guys are dead to me. You know.
half the comic book artist community that we know. You know.
Exactly. We're like the tiniest part of the comic book community, it seems like. So I feel like we should all be friends because there ain't too many of us. We're like the last of the mammoths or something getting into a fight. You guys should be sticking together because. Oh, well. Don't say it, Gib. Don't say it is what it is. For God's sake, don't say it.
No, that's not what I was going to. I mean, that's what I was really
that's, well, that's
I
what
was going to say that, you know.
I know. And it's like,
no, I was basically
what is he saying? Like, what does that mean? It's pretty much like you figured out, Jeff. All right, go ahead. Sorry, don't tie him up.
You set it off for me, dude. It's all
I'm sorry. I could just see it coming. That was all. I'm sorry, dude.
All good. I'm quitting the 100s tonight, though, over this.
I got you hardwired in, dude, for 100 shows. Maybe we should do 99. Let's do 98. Well, I'll do them.
There you go. The battle for the least number is coming. Somebody's going to do the one. Marsh is going to do the 4 minute, the 4 minute challenge.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We do 29 comics down or whatever.
29 minutes.
No, dude. 101 days of making comics. Just to outdo everybody.
Invented by Gibber and Redinger. That's why we're all following
him. That's right. Everybody follow me. That's right. Off the cliff.
He's the godfather of the 101s.
Man.
Yeah, the 101s. That's right.
I like that. Maybe that should be the new.
The 101st Airborne. There's an air. Oh my God. Yeah. You're going to get mixed up with the 101st Airborne.
Better just call themselves the Flying Tigers. That'll be
the Flying Tigers. The Flying Shit. We're gonna be called the Flying Shit Bags.
Yeah.
The 101 Flying Shit Bags. The Flying Dirt Bags. And you know, it's 101 days of getting on the internet and crying about having to work on your comic that you decided you wanted to work on.
That's catchy.
Yeah, you know.
It says he did about 170-ish days Were you just losing count, dude, or how did that happen?
Jesus Christ. Fucking overachiever. Calm the fuck down.
I think I'm around day 99. Let's do an extra 3 days just to make sure.
107. Wait, one sec.
Yeah.
You need a calendar.
One, five, 12. What'd you count that on? Fucking binary. 1, 0, 1, 1, 0, 0. That's how I count push-ups.
Yeah.
No. But Killreaver is jumping high there, dude. He's got the Michael Jordan pose going and shit. He's fixing to fuck some shit up. It's like Michael Jordan at the free throw line right there.
Something like that.
And Creed, did you ever finish that Plastic Man sticker? I didn't see that one ever show up. I saw the
I got the weed done, just his head. But what I want to do is I want to do a body. But to do the body, I want him holding the Plastic Man bong. So it's all like I have to do this before that and that before this, and so it's still in the works. But it's gonna be an awesome set though. And I'm thinking like I was thinking in my head, I'm like, okay, if Plastic Man turned himself into a bong, it wouldn't just be a bong that looked like Plastic Man. He'd have an arm coming out with a lighter. I'm like, yeah, there we go.
It's gonna be good.
There's a guy that goes by the name Beck, and he does a ton of cart, like almost what I do, but he does almost everyone is to do with stoner stuff, and he sells like a nut. So I'm thinking, man, the guy's name is the weed that'll get me started. I mean.
Hell yeah.
And I know at least in Canada it's completely legal here. Like I just buy it from the government.
There you go.
It's surreal. You're waiting in line, just like a liquor store, in a well lit place with shelves and all people in uniform behind the counter going, "Oh, which weed would you like?" I'm like, "This is insane." Like 3 years ago, if you had some in your pocket and you see a cop car drive by, you have a stroke. It's like, oh man, what a strange world.
Yeah, it is weird. I agree with that. It is super weird for it to be legal, especially the first time you go and stuff, and you're like, what the fuck, man? So nobody, this is okay. You're really gonna sell this right to me?
It's like, yeah, you're really. This isn't like I want a speedboat, and then the cops are gonna arrest me, is it?
Exactly.
Well, it's so weird is like when I lived in Tacoma, Washington, it was all like they had all these jars and they would just fill jars up in baggies for you. But in Colorado, they had that shit like set up like industry stuff. Everything was like vacuum sealed, ready to go, pre-weighed out, like set up, you know, like just showing up or cutting open boxes and putting it on the shelf. It was like a fucking straight up like, whoa, big business has showed up here to Colorado with the weed.
Yeah, our stuff's all packaged. Like, there's different brands from different companies. Stuff I get's in a metal can. Like, it's crazy.
Yeah, it is crazy.
But you know what? It's everybody's going to have all this money. Instead of just going wherever, it's all going into filling potholes and keeping schools open. And, like, that's genius because everybody's still going to smoke anyway. So you might as well do that. You know, that's what I think.
Yeah. Just like the lotto down here, the way that a lot of these states did the lottery, that stuff's all supposed to help the schools. It's basically how they get away with all that stuff, too.
Yeah. Like if you want to bring casinos that are provincial casinos.
And if you want to bring something in that's kind of like, it's sketchy, you just got to make sure you're doing it for the children. It's like, I don't know, heroin.
Captain Creed just said it was okay.
Oh, boy.
Captain
Comic. That was Captain Comics Gate, dude. I confused it too. That's his evil twin brother.
Captain. Wait, what's going on?
I don't know what's going on. Yeah, see that's the Captain Comics Gate taking over right there. He's blacking out. It's like the black suit Spider-Man and shit. He like goes to sleep, and Captain Comics Gate wakes him up. He doesn't know it. You should be writing all this down, Frank. This is gold. This is gold.
Sure.
Comic book gold. You already knocked that.
What would be the logo?
Right? Uh-oh.
Yeah, I just need to put it up.
Good to go, man. He's already
the one with the. Yeah, I just need to get him print it out. That's it. We actually had a flash flood warning yesterday and today, all day. Oh, really? There was a tornado warning last night, so I haven't gone out.
Mm. Yeah, there's a tornado warning on the coast right now here in Tejas.
Yeah.
So, yeah, man. Well, be careful, dude. Get that suit on and start saving people.
Yeah.
Has he got a flotation device on that vest? You may need one.
Huh?
You might have to go get the courage boat.
Fire up the ark.
The ark?
Yeah. Keep chugging that C4 water, man. You can eat it.
Excuse me. I'm bringing it back. Daniel Burnley is here. How's it going, man? Welcome to the show.
Bruno.
Yeah, Jib or somebody was asking, does Captain Courage endorse pot? That's what they were saying.
Whoa, I didn't say that. Jesus.
Whoa. What? I've got some conversations here.
Whoa.
He's a kid's hero. He whatever he does on his own time is his own thing.
Yeah, he's in the courage layer. And
he does it.
That would be no to both. It is not courage.
I like to tell kids myself to say no to drugs because, you know, there's limited supply and I need some. You know, you got to keep them all off it. Stay off it, kids, for God's sake.
Stop using up all the drugs.
Like I smoke a lot. Like, you know, don't use it all.
Oh, man.
There it is. Smoking like a true pothead.
Yeah, it's legal here in Colorado, but I don't even smoke.
Like, I'm at the point, like, I used to just do it for fun, but now it actually helps me, like, double what my medicine does, so.
Now you're serious about it.
Yep. I'm making stoner art. That's pretty serious.
Yeah. Well, I didn't think about that. Is that why you kind of go to that little bit more risque with your stickers and stuff, you know, like the weed and stuff?
Well, I was thinking about that because, I mean, I do little fringy stuff like that. I mean, I am a stoner, so this come up and I'm doing a villain called the weed. I mean, this is an opportunity. Like, if I just drew him and went, oh, that's the weed. No, that's no. So I might as well just, yeah. But I like in my mind, the stuff I do is almost for kids because, like, people will go, well, it's cartoons. But if you think about it, no, it's for kids from 1984. So who are those people? They're all old, bald bastards, you know.
Yeah.
So like nothing I draw is out of like it's not a kid's anything. Nothing I do is for kids. Kids these days do not give a shit about Underdog or like Inhumanoids or something.
Yeah. Well, no, I mean that is kind of true. But then there is like more racy, you know, like when you think about the Simpsons and stuff, they slip stuff like that in all the time, you know.
Well, I do like, and not to offend anybody who's religious, because this is an anti-religious thing. It's just I like the symbolism. I'm gonna do. Actually, I want to do the devil from that thing you were watching last night, the Mark Twain thing. I want to draw that guy, and then I already have a pair of demonic praying hands, so I want to make a satanic sticker pack. That'd be cool.
Oh, Lordy,
that is a creepy devil with that mask.
Yeah.
Yeah, that was weird.
Have a nightmare.
I thought it was scary. As a kid, and I think anything else. Cool.
Yeah,
but I think it's my metalhead side that I'm just like, yeah, satanic imagery is like, you know, think about it. It's on every album cover and van in the '80s. So I'm like, yeah, I think I'm gonna. I already have a little bit, but I've never turned it into anything. But. Right. And the weird thing is, when I think I'm stepping outside of cartoons and I'm like, oh, I think, you know, somebody's going to say something. No, sometimes that stuff gets even more likes. So I'm like,
yeah. know, isn't that weird? I always kind of worry about that stuff too, and then I end up doing something that's like either people don't notice or
say
anything. You know, like,
you're worried, like, oh, this is tremendous. Am I going to do this? Am I not? You do it, and there's like nobody. It's like it's like Last Action Hero when Buddy shot the guy. He was in the real world, and he shot the guy, and he looked around. He's like, I shot a man. And the guy's like, shut the hell up down there. And he's like, he kind of looks like, oh, crap. Nobody's coming.
Yeah.
That's kind of how I look at, like, diverging from your brand. I'm like, my brand is me, so whatever I do is my brand.
Right.
Yeah, that's definitely.
I like that. That's a nice piece,
yeah. Well, we were talking about darker stuff. So I was like, yeah, you know, I don't really post a lot of darker stuff, but and draw, definitely draw it.
That is nice. Yeah. Right on. Yeah. There's power in like heavy metal, kind of like evil. Like, in you know, I'm not even saying it's about evil, but it's, you know, it's the theme.
Darker,
more cult style art. There's power in that stuff.
The power of the devil.
I've probably been asked more than most normal people if I'm a Satanist. I'm not a, and my answer is always, and I'm not, but my answer is always nope, just a fan. It's like if somebody's wearing an AC/DC shirt, you're not going to go, oh, are you an AC/DC? So if I draw something satanic, right, somebody go, are you the satanic? I'm like, no, man, I'm an artist.
Yeah.
You're just weird.
I am just weird. And the people that don't like me, just because I'm weird in a different way than they're weird. That's all it is.
Yeah.
There we go.
Cool. Is that a sticker?
Yeah, they're like little, like, cut out things neat. I did. Making like little Valentine cards one year. A bunch of little evil, like,
you old softy.
Kill death. You got me with like a arrow through the eye. It's one of my favorite ones, though. I kind of want to make a sticker out of that one.
Yeah, that'd be a good sticker.
When your kids are in grade 5 and they go with those.
Yeah. I'll have anything for Valentine's Day. Here, have a Halloween. Give them to the other kids.
Yeah, give them to the kids. That'd be great.
And then just sit by the phone waiting for it to ring.
Yeah.
Hell yeah. No, our kids are homeschooled, so they don't have to. Homeschooled, so I don't have to answer to the school district.
No, your phone rings. It's your wife. Did you give the kids those?
Stop
that. You're damn right I do. She wouldn't even, no, she wouldn't call and ask. She would be like, it wouldn't be like, did you? It'd be like, why the hell did you? Because she'd already know I'd do it. She'd already be like, what the hell? I'll start saving up the money. Just print some things out.
She'd already had these. Why buy new ones?
Like, well, you need to go up there and pick up the little one, and the police are going to be there. Just kidding.
Yeah.
Well, actually, we have hit the 2-hour mark. So,
an herd has been made.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Accomplished another day of comics. So let's see. Let's go around the room and you can throw out your links of where everybody can find you and all that kind of stuff. So let's start with you, Frank, since you're bottom right-hand corner.
All right. You can find me on Salazar Art Nation on YouTube, also Salazar Art Nation on Instagram. And if you want to read some of the comics I've already done and put up, they're on Instagram at Salazar Nation Comics. So you can check those out. And you can buy some Captain Courage shirts also on my Teespring store.
Yeah, those shirts look really cool. And they're cheap too, they're like 15, 16 bucks. So.
Yeah, I know, man.
Yeah. And Randy Siplon, where can people find you?
You can just look me up on basically every social media at Randy Siplon. And I also have a new shirt up on Teespring. Nice. And yeah. Cool.
Yeah, that shirt looks great too.
Thanks.
Yeah. Creed, how about you?
Where can I usually say my site, but probably if you want to just keep up with what I'm doing, Creed Stonegate on Instagram and Creed Stonegate on Twitter. And those are mostly pop culture retromaniac posts, like a big feed of it daily on Instagram.
Yeah. And if you're a pothead that needs some stickers, definitely head over.
Exactly. Usually you will be excited about my upcoming products.
Gibran, where can I get this awesome brain skull sticker?
Oh, you can't. That's what you can't get. But yeah, you can get my comic book is on Webtoons. It's Doomed Barbarian on Webtoons. And then you can also find me on YouTube at Gibran Redinger. Just type my name in, my long, weird-ass name, and you will find me. That's it.
Yep. And I'm Jeff Lafferty. You guys are on my channel. Berserkernauts over there on Indiegogo. In demand, so if you buy one, I'll send one to you tomorrow. Thanks for watching, everybody. See you next time.